गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, वेलकम बैक टू द क्लास ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स। टूडे आई एम विद द असाइनमेंट सॉल्यूशन ऑफ चैप्टर 14, दैट इज सिमेट्री। सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस फर्स्ट द असाइनमेंट सॉल्यूशन ऑफ चैप्टर 14, आफ्टर दैट आई विल असाइन यू द होमवर्क। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद क्वेश्चन नंबर वन। क्वेश्चन नंबर वन वी आर हैविंग इज वी हैव टू ड्रॉ ऑल लाइन्स ऑफ सिमेट्री इफ एनी फॉर ईच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग फिगर्स। इट मीन्स वी हैव टू ड्रॉ ऑल द लाइन्स ऑफ सिमेट्री इफ एनी फॉर द फिगर्स गिवन बिलो। वी हैव गिवन 10 पार्ट्स, सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद ए पार्ट। दिस इज द शेप वी हैव गिवन। नाउ व्हेन दिस फिगर इज फोल्डेड अलोंग दिस लाइन, I will find that this figure, the parts of this figure will completely overlap when folded along this vertical line. So that I can say that this line acts as a line of symmetry for this figure and this is vertical line of symmetry. So it has only one line of symmetry, that is vertical line of symmetry. Come to B part. B part we have is an English alphabet J. We have to draw line of symmetry if it is having. So let us know this. If I fold this letter along the horizontal or vertical line, I will see those two parts will not overlap. So I can say this letter does not have any line of symmetry. Come to C part. C part we have given. Now through observation, I can say that if I fold it along horizontal line, I will get two parts that will overlap. Or if I fold it along vertical line, again they will overlap. So this figure has two lines of symmetry, that are horizontal and vertical. Come to D part. D part we have is an English alphabet H. So we have to draw the lines of symmetry. On folding through the vertical line or horizontal line, we will find that if I fold them, they will overlap each other. Those parts completely overlap each other. That's why I can say that this figure also have two lines of symmetry, that is vertical line of symmetry and horizontal line of symmetry. Come to part E. We have given an equilateral triangle. This we have learned many times that an equilateral triangle is a regular polygon. So it has, as it is having three sides, so line of symmetry is same as that of number of sides. So we have three lines of symmetry as drawn in this figure. From each vertex there will be one line of symmetry. This is 1, 2 and 3. So we have three lines of symmetry in an equilateral triangle. Come to F part. F part we have given the ends are semicircular and these are two straight lines. So in this figure I can say that it has two lines of symmetry, horizontal line of symmetry as well as vertical line of symmetry. This figure does not have a diagonal line of symmetry, because on folding through any of the diagonal we will find that those parts will not overlap. However, they will be equal but they will not overlap each other. This we have observed in the case of rectangle also, that rectangle does not have a diagonal as a line of symmetry. Come to G part. G part we have given this figure. Through observation and I can find that on folding through vertical line or horizontal line, those two parts completely overlap each other when folded. So this figure has two lines of symmetry and these should be drawn like this. Come to H part. It is a simple quadrilateral. What type of quadrilateral we can't say because nothing is given. So this is a quadrilateral, we can't say anything about this. So it does not have any line of symmetry. So this figure does not have line of symmetry. Come to I part. I part we have given is a circle and we have to draw the lines of symmetry. As we know that whenever this circle is folding along any of the line, any of the diameter, I will find that parts, those parts will completely overlap each other. So a circle has infinite number of lines of symmetry. I have drawn a few of them, but a circle has infinite lines of symmetry. Now come to J part. J part we have given is this figure. Observing this carefully, I can find that this figure has horizontal line of symmetry, because on folding along this line, I will find that these two parts will completely overlap with each other. So we can say that this figure has only one line of symmetry, and that should be like this, that is horizontal line of symmetry. So this is all about question number one. Hope you understood. Now come to question number two. Question number two you have is define reflection and rotational symmetry with examples. This I have explained many times. So let us discuss first about reflection symmetry. For that, you first know the definition of line symmetry. A figure has a line symmetry if there is a line about which the figure may be folded so that the two parts of the figure will coincide. It means a figure has line symmetry if about a line when the figure is folded, the two parts of the figure will coincide. And this line act as a mirror line also. That's why this type of symmetry is also known as reflection symmetry. Examples may be equilateral triangle, square. These are the two easiest example you can give in line symmetry. So this is all about line symmetry or reflection symmetry. Now come to the rotational symmetry. Rotational symmetry means if after a rotation, or you can say in a complete revolution or in a complete turn, an object looks exactly the same, then we can say that the figure has the rotational symmetry. Examples: circle has rotational symmetry of infinite order, an equilateral triangle has rotational symmetry of order 3. So we can say that if after a rotation when an object looks exactly the same, then we can say it has rotational symmetry. So this is all about question number 2. Now come to question number 3. Question number 3 we have is, which capital letters of English alphabet have no line of symmetry? Means we have to find all the capital letters of English alphabet that have no lines of symmetry. So these are the letters that are not having the lines of symmetry, and that are F, G, J, L, N, P, Q, R, S and Z. These letters does not have any line of symmetry. So this is your question number 3. Now come to question number 4. Does the figure given below have rotational symmetry? We have given the figure and we have to tell either this figure has rotational symmetry or no. As in the question, it is not mentioned that you have to tell the rotational symmetry of order 1 or order more than 1. If it is not mentioned in the question, then you have to understand that they are asking for the rotational symmetry of order more than 1. Whenever this type of question comes, when the question is asking about the figure given below has rotational symmetry or not, then yourself you have to understand that they are asking you about the rotational symmetry of order more than 1. So let us discuss. Here we will understand that we will give the answer in reference to the rotational symmetry of order more than 1. It does not have rotational symmetry of order more than 1 because these four parts we have given, and this is unshaded part. Just because of this part, we can say that this figure does not have rotational symmetry of order more than 1. Let us suppose if this part is also will also be shaded, then only this figure have the rotational symmetry of order more than 1, and then it will have the order of rotational symmetry as 4. So now, as because of unshaded part, this figure does not have rotational symmetry of order more than 1. Now come to question number 5. Tell whether the figure has rotational symmetry of order more than one or not. We have to tell either the following figures have rotational symmetry or not. So this is the first. Now you have to tell either this figure has rotational symmetry of order more than one or no. So let us revolve. Let us try to revolve this figure. On revolution, I will find that in a complete turn, this figure will not get the shape as that of the original one. Same shape as that of the original one. So I will say that this figure does not have rotational symmetry of order more than one. So this is no. Come to this, as this is semicircle given. This we have done in the exercise question also, that a semicircle does not have rotational symmetry of order more than one, because on rotating this figure through the center, I will find that there is no angle that this figure should be same as the original one. Rotated figure should be same as the original one. That's why this figure does not have rotational symmetry of order more than one. Now come to C part. C part we have given is a rhombus. We have to find either this figure has rotational symmetry or not. So, as we have learned in the chapter that a rhombus has rotational symmetry of order 2 and its angle of rotation is 180. So this figure has rotational symmetry of order more than 1. Come to D part. D part we have given is this figure. Now if I start rotating in clockwise direction, I will find that at 90, 180, 270 and 360, I will get the same shape of rotated figure as that of original one. So I can say that this figure has rotational symmetry of order 4, that is having rotational symmetry of order more than 1. Come to E part. E part we have given is an English alphabet C, and we have to find either this figure has rotational symmetry of order more than 1 or not. So let us try to rotate it through the center. Now on rotating, I will observe that this figure will not be same as, at any angle, this figure will not be same as that of original one. So I can say this figure does not have rotational symmetry of order more than one. So this is all about the solution part of assignment. We have completed the chapter. Now you have to prepare for the test. So your homework is, you have to prepare for the test of chapter 14, symmetry. And after this, we will start our new chapter, that is chapter 3, data handling. So prepare well. All the very best. Thank you.